I'm really bad at starting these kind of videos. Today I'm gonna bake brownies. To be precise, I'm gonna be doing white chocolate and raspberry brownie recipe. I made these but without the raspberries in them a couple weeks ago for my family, and everyone really liked them, so hopefully they turn out well and they taste good and you can make them at home if you wish. I don't know if it's just me, during the lockdown period baking has become a massive hobby of mine. It's just whenever I'm bored I start baking, which I never really used to do. Brownies has been one of the things that I've made, and these ones are really good. So I am gonna do a baking video and show you how to make these. So also, as I'm sure many of you are aware, due to the COVID-19 situation lockdown at the moment in the UK, sadly the 2020 graduates, they will not be having like a graduation ceremony this year, which is sad. So obviously they will be having just some form of online graduation, doing things at home, and to help with that, the uni have come out with little things that people can print off to make a sort of form of Stirling University graduation for yourself at home, including little cake toppers, which I've not printed out yet, but I have them here. I'll maybe actually insert them bigger on the screen, and they're really cute. And so I will be printing a few of them out and showing you them and displaying them on my brownies at the end. But without further ado, I feel like I should get on with actually doing the recipe, because that's what the point in the video is. So yeah, so if you would like to see how to make some really tasty white chocolate and raspberry brownies, then stay tuned. Okay, so I have all my ingredients pre-laid out because I get stressed when I'm baking. I really don't want to have the stress showing on camera. So I've made it as stress-free for myself as possible. And so I have all of my ingredients here, and I will talk you through what they all are. Okay, so the ingredients that we have are 185 grams of butter. Then I have 100 grams of dark chocolate and 85 grams of milk chocolate. Then we have 100 grams of white chocolate, roughly chopped up into chunks. 3 large eggs, 40 grams of cocoa powder, 85 grams of plain flour, 120 grams of raspberries, and 275 grams of caster sugar. You can use either brown caster sugar, I think that's what it's called, a golden caster sugar, or just regular white, which is what I've got. So, what is the next step? I actually don't know. Okay, right, next bit. I have already put my oven on and I've preset it to 180 degrees Celsius for a fan oven. Okay, so I have now moved position. So your first step is you now take your bowl that you have the 100 grams of dark chocolate and the 85 grams of milk chocolate, and obviously I've broken them up into like little squares, and then what we're gonna do next is you're gonna add the butter and sort of cut it up into sort of like smaller bits so it's just not one big piece. You're gonna put the butter and the chocolate into one bowl. Now you can do it the proper way, which is where you fill a like saucepan with hot water and then you get a heat proof dish and you put it over the water and you melt it that way. But I'm doing it the student way, aka the easy way, and I'm gonna do it in the microwave. But when you're doing this, just be careful not to burn the chocolate. So the best way to do that is just sort of maybe like every 20 to 30 second intervals at first, and then after that maybe 10 seconds, just to make sure that you're not overdoing it, because a lot of the time, even if the chocolate hasn't fully melted, you'll find that just within the heat of itself it will start to melt. So yeah, we're just gonna do that step just now. Butter and chocolate mixture. So I actually only ended up putting it in the microwave for about a minute and 20 seconds in total. So the first two were 30 seconds and then the last one was 20. And then just kind of like by mixing it, you can really just melt the chocolate within the heat of the butter itself. So yeah, and now what you just do is just put this aside for now. You can cover it if you want, but to be honest, you're gonna be using it soon enough anyway, you don't really need to. So we just leave it to the side just so that it's not really, really hot. So yeah, we're just gonna leave that to the side for now. Okay, so just before I move on to the next step, I'm just gonna grease my tin. This is a flexible one. My mom's, I'm at home, so I have all the nice baking utilities at the moment. And basically just to grease it, all I'm gonna do is take a little bit of butter and put it on a piece of kitchen paper, and just sort of like smear it around it. So yeah, I'm just gonna do that quickly before I move on to the next step. So as I said before, I'm living with my parents at the moment. Which means I have this fancy electric mixer that I can use. But obviously you don't need this to be able to do this recipe at all. You just do it by hand, or if you have like an electric, like a hand electric whisker, that works too. The next thing we're gonna do is put the eggs and the sugar together. Basically you're whisking the eggs and the sugar together to make them kind of like fluffy and a bit thicker. I don't know the science of baking, but I think it just makes the brownie slightly fluffier and a nicer texture. So that's what we're gonna do just now. You're gonna break your 3 eggs to your bowl. along with your sugar, and then you're just gonna whisk them together. I'm just gonna do that just now, and once it gets the right consistency, I will show you so you can kind of like refer to it. So yeah. Consistency that you're looking for, you see? And you don't want to move it around like I just did too much, because then obviously it will take the air out of it. Okay, so now that you have your kind of milkshakey consistency stuff with your sugar and your eggs, now what you're gonna do is we're gonna take the chocolate and butter mixture and you're gonna fold it through, being careful not to take, again, take too much of the air out of the sort of egg and sugar mixture. So yeah, I'll show you that. I'm now going to sieve in the cocoa powder and the flour. You can actually just dump these into one and sieve them at the same time, that's fine. And you're going to repeat the same folding action to bring this in, because again, you're trying to avoid taking as much air out of the mixture as possible. So yeah, next step is adding the cocoa powder and the flour. Okay, so now that you have this with all your cocoa powder and everything in it, final step of the kind of baking process is adding your raspberries and your white chocolate. I would say add the white chocolate first, because it's not gonna get battered and bruised like the raspberries are. So I would say put the white chocolate in first, mix that through lightly, and then the raspberries. Dream of you every night. Dream of you. Can I help it if I dream of you every night? Dream of you. Can I help it if I dream of you? Okay, so as you saw, I just mixed in the raspberries and the white chocolate chunks and then popped them into the baking tray that I prepared earlier. And then I've just put them into the oven at the preset temperature of 180 degrees Celsius for a fan oven. You should leave them for around about 25 minutes, although last time I baked them, I found that I did leave them for a bit longer. So I'm gonna check them after 20 minutes just to see how they're doing. And then after that, just sort of like give them 5 minute intervals, and depending on when I think they're ready, then I'll take them out. So I guess you'll see them when they're ready on the other side.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. That you feel the same. I just wanna be the one you love, 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 love. I don't want to set the world on fire.
So there you have it. Some, I would say, pretty simple raspberry and white chocolate brownies that you could easily make during the lockdown period if you're enjoying your baking or if you want to start baking. I actually did end up baking these for quite a bit longer. Well, not quite a bit longer, but I would say maybe closer to 35 minutes. But I think that might just have been because my baking tray was quite deep. As you can see, my family have already kind of attacked these and had a few, but they're enjoying them. And I got the sister seal of approval as well. So yeah, I hope if you guys do try making these, then you enjoy them as much as myself and my family did. And also just sort of along the lines of these little things we have here, I just wanted to say a big congratulations to anybody who is graduating this year, and I'm really sorry from the bottom of my heart that you guys aren't getting a proper graduation ceremony, but you've done so well to get this far, and just a massive congratulations, and I hope that whatever you are doing, you have a great day and a great time. So thank you for watching, and I guess a happy graduation and happy baking.